Frenzy Pop is a lot to drink in. In this review, we're going to see what bubbles under the surface and if there's a great platformer here, or if the whole thing just fizzes out. Continuing with these puns would definitely be the last straw, so let's have a look at this soda-themed game. The levels are what one may call snack-sized. You need to get to the vending machine at the end as quickly as possible. The speed in which you reach it signifies whether you get a bronze, silver, or gold bottle cap at the end of each level. Buttons control your movement. Left and right act how you would expect them to. Up has you jumping and down turns you into a Samus Morph Ball. There's also the PP button, which flips your bottled protagonist on his head, allowing the chemical reaction of shaken up carbon dioxide to propel him along in a sort of flying hover mode. There is a fuel bar for this special power, but it doesn't take long to fill back up when depleted. Seeing as the game is based around speedy completion, clever use of this is required for those elusive gold bottle caps. The controls are a little difficult to get your head around, however, and this isn't just the common problems on-screen buttons have with iPhone platformers that require timing and skill in execution. The wall jump in particular is an oddity. You will automatically bounce off a wall like it's a trampoline, but only at random times will this propel you in the desired height to make your leap worthwhile. Often you need to double jump on your wall jump, which seems a less elegant solution, especially due to those times the wall bounce works. With the tightening of the controls and perhaps a little more visual flair, this could be a must-buy for those that like such platformers as League of Evil. The level design is decent and more levels and updates are promised. This one's a little too rough around the edges for a recommendation, but there will be those who can look past its faults enough to dive into the speedrunning mechanics underneath. This has been Andrew with AppSpy.com. We review, you decide.